great crowd in this arena. They're noisy too and appreciative. They know this sport very well. We've had some great events in Kuala Lumpur and lots of great fighters, both from this town and from elsewhere.
Ready? Fight!
Mizuno against Galva, brought to you by Under Armour. Hold on to your armchairs at home, folks. This one could be quick and explosive. Oh, big punches coming in from Galva. Head and body. Oh, huge right hand. Mizuno took with his back to his opponent, and he's locked with his face pressed up against the cage now as Galvao, with that huge upper body, does all he can to disable him.
Now, Mizuno is a third-degree black belt in judo, but in this fight, he's probably going to be using that judo ability for as takedown defense rather than throwing his opponent, but he gets dragged to the mat there.
He's being ragdolled a little bit, Mitch, and he's a big man, Mizuno.
Galvao is so strong and powerful. He is just taking the big man for a ride. But he is a high-level black belt from Brazil. So you can see he's almost got the back. He's got one hook. He's trying to lace that other hook, but good reversal
nice work
there.
From Mizuno.
Now Mizuno's got hit. Galvao's back. Galvao pops right back up. He's throwing possibly a back elbow there. You can see him sort of thinking about it. A weapon we've seen used to devastating effect before.
Eric Kelly's very good at that, but Tatsuya Mizuno with his head turned away.
Oh, Mizuno jumps onto the back.
What can he do with this, Mitch?
There's a possible choke, but he's a little bit high. He could roll into an armbar there. If he falls off the end there, he does have a possible armbar, but it's going
to
be tough against Galvao, who's so experienced on the ground.
Quite a bit of work to do. Now, what can Galvao do in this position?
Well, he might just stand up and really start to unload some bombs here. But Mizuno's got his legs kind of intertwined and as he's kind of got hooks in, but he's a little bit too high. Yeah, see, now Galvao's just going to jump all over him. Now he's got the back. This is really a back and forth battle.
When he lands those blows to the face there, heavy, heavy fist he's got.
Oh, man, I can feel the vibration through the cage over here on their commentary booth.
Looks like he's got very big hands.
Looks like he's kind of shaking the hair of Rich Franklin a little bit.
Come on, look. Fight!
Southpaw Mizuno. Looking a little bit shaken, actually, and he just got himself underneath that overhand right from Galvao, so heavily muscled. I wonder how long Galvao can keep a good pace up.
Yeah,
quite often these muscle-bound characters, it doesn't go for very long.
We've seen it before, that all that muscle just sucks the oxygen out of your body and it can fatigue you really fast.
Oh, big left hand after he threw a right as well.
Especially when you have those grappling exchanges, but those are some big paws coming out of Mizuno's head.
Mizuno was rocked, and if Galvao is gonna struggle with cardio, he needs to finish it now, but he's gone down. And Mizuno sees an opening here. Galvao comes back up to his feet.
He just stood right back up. Now Mizuno's got to be nice and patient like he's known for. He's got that left hook coming off. You got to be wondering, I mean, you're bringing up a good point, Steve. Is the cardio going to be a big factor, especially as we start to approach the second round here? I don't know if he was shaking it off saying that didn't hurt me or he got disgusted at himself for getting caught with it, but that 1-2 combination did look like it landed.
These guys know what their strengths are. 61 professional fights between them. If cardio is an issue for Galvao, he'll know about it and do all he can in this first round. He just took a huge knee. He's saying it was a central blow.
That looked close. It looked like it was a little like it could be low, so you know I can't say because I didn't get a clean look at it.
Let's see if we can get a replay. My first thought was that it wasn't, but let's reserve judgment until we see the replay. But if he is looking for a bit of time, a bit of a rest, then this is an ideal opportunity, Rich.
It is. If this is a foul, obviously the referee stops the fight here. He has the duration of a round, which is 5 minutes to actually recover from this. I'm assuming that he's going to.
Not quite the angle we wanted, but it did look like it was a bit low.
Oh, still hard to see.
A little bit obscured there from the vision.
I'm not sure it was that low. It seemed to me it came around the red belt there of his trunks. But anyway, look, we didn't take the blow. He did.
Obviously, this is an inadvertent foul, so there's no yellow card or no foul here. Joey Lapete then is warning him, and Galvao's not taking the full 5 minutes, so we're
good for
ready
him
for action.
Good for him. Okay. We
ready?
Resume.
Ready? Fight!
The very heavy-muscled Gilberto Galvao resumes action with Tatsuya Mizuno as Anthony Suntai calls for noise in this arena. It's barely needed because they're loving this contest. Galvao goes on the pursuit. A clash of knees.
He's throwing that knee really effectively.
Big overhand punches, all wild and swinging.
Galvao's kind of rushing in there, and you can just see the fatigue. Galvao's just slowing down a little bit. The punches are starting to come really wide. That knee, if it's timed correctly at the right moment when these two big men collide.
Oh, is Tatsuya Mizuno able to just pace himself slightly better? You get the feeling that maybe he's got that in his mind. And, oh, well, so Galvao's complaining about another foul blow. This time he's talking about finger in the eye. He's not blinking hard, though. There was a punch landed around the eye, whether a finger was stray or not. Again, perhaps we'll see in a replay. You get the impression that Galvao's looking for every little piece of respite he can. He lands a good straight right.
These strikes are landing, Steve. He did complain about a possible eye poke.
Well, he's blinking hard now, but I didn't see him blinking too hard while they were fighting.
But you always, a 10-year vet knows you always have to protect yourself. You can't look away. You have to keep your guard up. And let's take a look at some of this action.
Nah, that was a fist. I didn't see any fingers there. Rich Franklin?
They are open-handed gloves. Rich, what do you think?
I didn't see any fingers either. His hand was slightly open. Who knows if something landed in the eye, but it's enough to complain about. You got to keep an eye on that, but Lapita may have been at an angle where you couldn't see it anyway. Scoring in this round, they're all over the place. This is a tough one for me to score, but this is about the striking between the two of these guys. So far, I have Galvao just slightly ahead. It seems like the shots that he's landing are a bit heavier, possibly doing a bit more damage. But I'll tell you, listen, Galvao's shoulders have shoulders, and those muscles take oxygen. And it looks like he is running out of gas to me. So let's see what happens in this next set of 5 minutes.
That could be the story of this fight. Look at these fans. They are loving it as much as we are. There is a story to be told.
Galvao was on the stool for a little bit longer, so I think he's starting to breathe really heavy. His mouth's open, but Mizuno looks nice and light, ready to go.
You just know, experienced a man as Mizuno is, he'll know that there's probably a cardio issue with a man who's got, as Rich said, shoulders on his shoulders. And he'll be biding his time, knowing that it's a marathon, not a sprint. For Galvao, he'll be thinking about sprinting only, I suspect.
But those shoulder-bound shoulders are throwing some big punches. You know, each one of these things are coming very close. There's a big left kick there. See, that this shot still got power.
This is where Mizuno comes into his own.
But Mizuno looks nice and light. He still looks fresh.
Oh, right hand was so solid, and again, he's complaining about a low blow, and the fans don't like this. Well, you can't see everything from our position here. What I thought I saw was a punch to the face. There must have been something stray down there.
And he could have snuck in, but I thought he landed a punch on Mizuno. Oh, I don't think necessarily, but he looks hurt.
Well, what are you, Rich Franklin, any idea?
I actually was looking down. You'll see it here.
All right,
and
fair
I was
going
to say that I could hear the sound of a cup. Listen, this is a bad foul here. As I'm looking at Galvao in the cage, I'm not 100% he's going to recover from this.
Joey Lapete is wiping down. Oh, and he's just thrown the towel on my lap, actually, which is rather unpleasant. It looks as if we're going to get a resumption.
I think Galvao's ready to go. That's a warrior,
that
Steve.
Is a warrior, yeah.
He still looks a bit bothered, though. I don't know if we're going to get Galvao at 100%.
Ready,
but
ready?
I think he's toughing it out.
We resume. And I didn't think we would. I've got to be honest with you. Galvao throws a right hand that just clips the forehead of Mizuno. And Mizuno, I think, will fancy his chances here more than he has at any stage.
But there was a 5-minute break, so he's probably got that
cardio back. That's
true. You know, we're only about 4 minutes in so far, so we still got 4 minutes left in this round.
Yeah, that was a lengthy break for him to get his... good right hand. He followed it up with a left.
That connected well, Steve. That was a beautifully timed right hand thrown by Galvao.
And that five-minute rest effectively means that Galvao gets something similar to the first round opportunity he had when he's fairly fresh, albeit with the lingering pain of that groin shot.
He's probably going to be a bit hesitant to lunge in like he's been doing because that knee is so well timed from Mizuno. But Mizuno's got to be careful not to throw it again, because if he connects, he's going to get yellow carded.
And it's still Galvao inching forward every time. Takes a knee to the stomach, and there was a little bit of trepidation, wasn't there, from Galvao, but it was clearly in the stomach. But Mizuno has to be careful. Rich was saying he's had a verbal warning. Next comes the yellow card, and that could mean trouble.
But he's still throwing that knee, and these are better at the time. These are actually landing to the midsection of Galvao. So Mizuno's still patient, still biding his time, because you can see that Galvao has to close the distance to get close.
Mizuno's right hand so very low, and his left hand not much higher. With a fearsome puncher like Galvao in front of him, is that sensible?
You know, that's just his style. That's just kind of where he keeps his hands, and he likes to come up with the jab at a different angle. So that's kind of where he's been comfortable doing it, and that's sort of just his natural stance.
And he is pretty effective at just leaning out of range at the last second as well. So, yep, if that's his style, it's worked for him so far. Galvao still looking to just come inside and land a big right and a left, and that rocked Mizuno, no question. But he's a big man. He can take a few of these punches.
Both these fighters are trying to time their strikes so well. Galvao's trying to rush in, land those big punches.
You can see, though, that Galvao's just looking for that one huge haymaker, isn't he? He's loading up that right hand. You can see it's cocked and ready to go, isn't it? See?
Yeah, he rushes forward because he's at a reach disadvantage. And there's a big clubbing right hand that clipped the top of Mizuno's head.
That's really the only punch he's going for. The left is nothing more than a rangefinder maybe at the moment. He's just looking to land that right. And there it is. And it followed up with the left. And they were clean punches high to the head. And Mizuno took those very well.
Yeah, Mizuno's got a good chin, because that right hand of Galvao's is finding a home on the face of Mizuno. You gotta wonder, is this shifting the striking superiority more in his favor because he's landing these big
superb
shots?
Superb inside leg kick from Mizuno. That sets Galvao back a couple of paces. Final minute of this second round that's been stalled for us a couple of times due to illegal blows. Right and left, not clean blows from Galvao this time. 40 seconds left of the second round.
Basically just standing in front of each other, taking turns punching each other. That was Galvao's turn. Now I think it's Mizuno's turn.
30 seconds left in the second round.
Galvao skips a turn and goes right after him.
The thing is, he's not getting close enough to Mizuno, who's got the superior reach, and he's got excellent timing, Mizuno, just to back off out of range when Galvao comes and unleashes. He has been caught. We've seen that several times. But he's reducing the chances of a big finish with every second that goes by. Although, as I say that, a big right hand again lands high. And he's just got a little nick on the outside of his left eye that was bothering him. That happened in the very final exchange.
Landed that big right hand again to open the round. I'd like to see Mizuno start utilizing that jab and that
reach. Look at these kicks
reach.
Now. These are making the difference. Ooh. In comes Galvao with that big swinging right hand. This time he lands. But will Mizuno fire off more of these kicks?
He's not really utilizing his range and his distance the way that he should, unless he starts throwing these kicks. Now Galvao is starting to march forward. Shoots it for the takedown. Has the single leg. Transfers to the double. Mizuno's doing the right thing, utilizing that judo background to sort of defend the takedown.
Hold your shorts.
Good defense by Mizuno as he circles away from the cage. Well done.
If we come back to distance now and Mizuno starts with these kicks, just remember that he's in a dangerous position here because these kicks, if he goes for the inside leg, if any of them stray to the groin area, he'll be yellow carded, and that will have an effect on how the judges score this contest.
But his accuracy has improved. The final 4 minutes of that round, he was a lot crisper with a lot of his strikes.
Oh, left, right, left. A knee to the body from Mizuno.
The chin on Mizuno
is impressive, isn't it?
Pretty rock solid because he's taking some big shots. And Galvao's not even snapping the head back. Like, his chin is staying tucked. That's a good lesson for all you young fighters out there.
Good takedown. Well, that'll be noticed by the judges. I see Rich Franklin scribbling.
Yeah, that's a big takedown. That's a nice little shift in the tide. You know, as Galvao has been showing, like Rich said before, the striking superiority that Galvao has showed, now he secures a takedown, and this is his world. This is where he's been trying to get the fight.
We welcome our viewers from Astro in Malaysia to the third round of this wonderful contest, Gilberto Galvao against Tatsuya Mizuno. It is so close, hard for us to separate the two fighters here with only 2.5 minutes left of this contest. We've seen Galvao land some big, big blows, but he's struggling a bit with cardio. Meanwhile, he's been on the receiving end of some foul blows and had some time off to recover. Mizuno has shown a tremendously good chin, and here they are now with just over 2 minutes left, locked in a tussle, where the judges are looking very carefully to try and separate these two.
I like how Mizuno utilized the space created by Galvao as Galvao tried to wind up really big and throw a big left hand. Mizuno saw that little bit of space and used it to pop right back up. Nice little high level experience sort of tactic shown right there by Mizuno. Galvao trying to get this fight back down to the ground.
Galvao looking for the foot stomp and the knee to the thigh there. They stomp again.
Foot stomps.
One guy's work.
1.5 minutes left. Either fighter could win this just with something special in the last 90 seconds.
Oh, he tried to go for that Kimura takedown again, but it slipped off. And now he's got the big Brazilian on top of him. But Mizuno scrambles well.
Defensively, Mizuno has fought a very, very clever fight. Every ounce of his experience is helping him out here. He gets hammered up against the cage directly above us here.
Yeah, he scrambles really well. When he finds that little bit of space, he's able to use that little bit of space to create movement and get a scramble going and get back up to his feet.
Nice work, work.
Almost just grinding up against him as they fight for position up against the cage here. Just driving his head into the chin of Mizuno. Mizuno didn't like that, starts to push off.
We're inside the last half minute. Who knows how the judges will see this one. We'll try and get to Rich before the judges have their say to see how he sees this. But it's going to be very difficult to score, particularly this last round, I think. Mizuno goes after him in the final few seconds just to see if he can catch the judge's eye or score a very quick knockout. But the bell goes, the fight is over. Galvao puts his hand in the air. Mizuno puts his hands on his hips. Rich, how do you see this before the judges get involved?
Well, I'll tell you, that looks like a man defeated right there. I'll say that much. But look, this whole fight has basically been about striking superiority. I saw it as Galvao landing the heavier punches there, which is why he actually won that category. They're about dead even on damage inflicted. But Galvao also had more of the takedowns. I felt like he was a bit more aggressive in that last round. You know, we talked about Galvao's cardio, that the muscles take a lot of oxygen. And even though he had that break, being kneed in the groin like that takes a lot of gas out of you if it's ever happened to you before. So I'll say that I'm a bit surprised at the pace he was still able to push at the end of the fight. I personally have Galvao slightly ahead on this fight and would give him the decision.
Mitch, is that the way you'd see it? I know it's tough to call a fight when you're commentating and judging a fight at the same time. It's tough to do, but what do you think? Quickly.
Yeah, I got to agree with Rich. Very well done by Galvao. Interesting fight either way.
To present the medal for this fight, we have Mr. Adrian Chai, Chief Marketing Officer of Under Armour Southeast Asia. Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges see it for your winner via unanimous decision. From the blue corner, Gilberto Galvao!
As we saw it at cage side, it is Gilberto Galvao who takes the win.